I am alive and it is great to be alive. I'm going to be showing off my Witchfire Ember build today. This build focuses on having an insane amount of power strength as well as having a decent amount of survivability so that you can have a 100% guaranteed chance of setting enemies ablaze and also dealing tons of damage. So if we get into the build here, I'm going to go ahead and show off my mods. And yes, I do have a missing mod slot here because this is a very specialized build and I don't really want to polarize Ember because I don't want to compromise my main Phoenix flame build that I have over here. So for this build, I've simply got rejuvenation just because it's a matching polarity, which is great. I cannot wait for our next update to come out where we will get the universal polarity forma so that we can polarize our Warframe to equip any aura mod. That's going to be amazing. I've got blind rage, adaptation at max rank, which is pretty pricey and expensive, but well worth it. Umbral intensify, umbral vitality, streamline, transient fortitude, and redirection. This is going to get you an insane power strength of 299%, which is the main focus of this build. Your duration is going to suffer at 73% and your efficiency will be 75%, but your range will remain standard, which is pretty helpful. This build was just created in an attempt because I really have a nice balanced Ember build that I'm always using, but you guys know me, I love to just mess around, screw around with stats in Warframe and try to find something to have fun with. And so I just went all out on power strength, especially once I realized that Ember's ability to set enemies on fire with her ultimate is entirely dependent on power strength. I found that really interesting and never really paid attention to that before. This is all made far more noticeable with the nice power stat screen that we got a couple updates back. So naturally, with such a high power strength, sacrificing all other stat categories, these abilities are going to be more expensive than standard, but they are gonna freaking wreck. Ember's first ability, which is just her fireball she shoots out, is gonna do 1,196 damage. That is pretty freaking solid. The area damage is gonna be 448.5. And if you charge this ability, it has a really decent radius to it as well, so you can pretty much shoot mini nukes around the map. Her accelerant ability, while a little expensive with this build, is so freaking cool. It only lasts 21.75 seconds, but I think it's more than worth it. The damage multiplier is gonna be 7.47 to all fire damage. What in the F? That is insane, especially when combined with her ultimate. I don't really use her fire blast in this build because, well, all of her powers are more expensive, so there's just not enough to go around, and this one's just not a priority for me, but if you are curious, it does 598 explosion damage. The damage per second of enemies in the ring will be 672.75 damage, but it only lasts 14.5 seconds, so probably not what you want to be spending your energy on. And finally, her ultimate, World on Fire, one of the coolest abilities she has. The drain is super expensive. It is 5.17 and the cast is 62, but you know what? I think it's well worth it, especially as you'll see here in the gameplay. If you wait until you have a full energy bar, and even if you like polarize your build so that you can fit more mods than I can, you could even pop a prime flow on this bad boy and you would have much more efficiency. But the damage is 1,196 with a 104% status chance, so you are dealing over 1,000 damage per hit and it is guaranteed to light the enemy aflame. Not to mention, if you combine that with your accelerant ability, holy crap. So that's pretty much it. Not necessarily the most effective build, but I love messing around with stuff in Warframe. I love coming up with not only a new color customization, but then kind of a build to go with a weird theme such as Witchfire that I was going for here. So hopefully this inspires you all to make new builds and just find new ways to have fun in Warframe. Though I gotta say, I do still think that my Phoenix Flame Ember build is a really nice standard and solid way to go if you want to cover all your bases. So I will go ahead and have that in the description of the video in case you're interested in that. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace out, everyone.